Now let's see this example in AVL tree. Construct AVL tree for the elements 20, 11, 5, 32, 40, 22, 4, 27, 23, 28 and 50. So here the first element is 20. So insert 20. So the first element will become the root node. So 20 will become the root node. Here after inserting each node, we have to calculate balance factor. Balance factor is equal to height of the left subtree minus height of the right subtree. Here there is no left subtree and there is no right subtree. So the balance factor for this node is 0. Next, let us insert the next element. So insert 11. So what is the root element? 20. Compare 11 with 20. 11 is less than 20. So 11 should be inserted as the left child of 20. Next, we calculate balance factor from leaf node onwards. The balance factor for 11 is 0. Why? Because no left subtree and no right subtree. Whereas the balance factor for 20 is 1. Why? Because height of the left subtree is 1. There is no right subtree. So 1, 0. Here the balance factor is 0, 1. So there is no problem here. So when we can say that it is unbalanced? If the balance factor of a node is other than minus 1, 0, 1, then we can say that it is unbalanced one. Then we have to perform a rotation in order to make the tree as a balanced one. Okay. Next, let us insert the next one. The next element is 5. So insert 5. So the root element is 20. And next, its left children is 11. Next, compare 5 with root element. 5 is less than 20. So left children. Next, 5 is less than 11. So left children. Next, calculate balance factor from leaf node onwards. For 5, it is 0. Whereas for 11, 1 minus 0, 1. For 20, left subtree height is 1, 2. Whereas right subtree height is 0. Okay. So 2 minus 0 means 2. So we can say that here this is unbalanced node. Why? Because for 20, the balance factor we got is 2. So we have to perform a rotation now. So which rotation we have to perform? This is nothing but left subtree. This is nothing but left children. That means we have to perform LL rotation. We have to perform which rotation? LL rotation. LL rotation means we have to rotate right side. So here which node is unbalanced one? 20 is the unbalanced one. So we have to rotate 20 towards right side. Then 11 will becomes the root node. 11 will becomes the root node. And 20 is shifted towards right side. So 20 will becomes the right children. Whereas 5 will become the left children. Okay. So it is very, very easy to perform the rotation here. Here we have three elements, 20, 11, 5. So we know what is balance, we know what is binary search tree. What is binary search tree? Left subtree contains values less than the root. Right subtree contains the values greater than the root. So between 20, 11, 5, which is the middle element? So 11, 11 is having middle value, okay? Why? Because 5 is the lesser value, 20 is the larger value. So that middle range value will become the root node. 5 will become the left subtree, whereas 20 will become the right subtree. Why? Because AVL tree is nothing but binary search tree only. But it maintains balance factor. Next, to calculate balance factor for each and every node. For 5, it is 0. For 20, it is 0. For 11, left subtree height is 1, right subtree height is 1. 1 minus 1 means 0. So this is balanced 1. Next, let us insert the next one. So insert 32. Insert 32. So what is the tree we have? 11, next to 5, next to 20. Now we have to insert 32. 32 is greater than 11, so right side. 32 is greater than 20, so right side. Next, we calculate balance factor from each and every node. For 5, it is 0. For 32, from leaf node onwards, we have to calculate the balance factor. For 32, 0 minus 0, 0. Whereas for 20, we don't have left subtree, so 0 minus. Whereas the right subtree height is 1. So 0 minus 1 means minus 1. For 11, left subtree 1, whereas right subtree 2. 1 minus 2 means minus 1. So we got balance factor as 0 minus 1. So we can say that this is balanced 1. No need to apply any rotation. Let us insert the next one. The next one is 40. So insert 40. Insert 40. Then what will happen? 11 is the root node. Next, its left children is 5. Next, the right subtree 20, 32. 20, 32. Next we have to insert 40. So 40 is greater than 11, so right side. 40 is greater than 20, so right side. 40 is greater than 32, so right side. So next we calculate balance factors. So 0 for 32, it is left subtray is 0, whereas the right subtray is 1. So 0 minus 1 means minus 1. Next for 20, left subtray is 0, whereas the right subtray is 2. So 0 minus 2 means minus 2. So we can say that this is balanced one. Okay, there is no need to calculate balance factor for the remaining nodes. Okay, why? Because this 20 is unbalanced one. So which rotation we have to perform? So this is nothing but right side, right subtray. So this is nothing but right child. So we need to perform RR rotation now. RR rotation means we have to perform left rotation. RR means LL rotation means we have to perform right rotation. Whereas RR rotation means we have to perform the left rotation now. So what is the root node here? 11 is the root node and 5 is its left children. And next 20 is unbalanced one. So we have to move 20 towards the left side. Then what will happen? 32 will become the root node, and the 20 is shifted towards left side. So 20 will become its left children, whereas 40 will become its right children. So here it is very very simple here. 20, 32, 40. So 20 is lesser value. So 20 is left children. 40 is higher value. So 40 will become the right children. So what is the middle value? 32. So 32 will become the parent node. Okay. So very very simple here. Next we calculate the balance factor. 0, 0. This is 1, this is 1. 1 minus 1, 0. So this is nothing but 0. Next for 11 it is left subtree height is 1. Whereas the right subtree height is, this is 1, this is 1. 1 plus 1, 2. So 1 minus 2 means minus 1. So we can say that it is balanced one. Next we have to insert 2. So insert 2. So if you insert 2, then 11. Next 5. Next what is the tree? 32. Next 20. Next 40. So we have to insert 2 now. So 2 is less than 11. So left side. Next 2 is less than 5. So left side. Calculate the balance factor. So 0. For 5 it is 1. Because 1 minus 0 is 1. For 11 it is. So 1, 1, 2. 1, 2. So 2 minus 2 is 0. For 20 is 0. For 40 is 0. For 32. Left subtree height is 1. Right subtree height is 1. So 1 minus 1 means 0. For 11. Left subtree height is 2. Whereas right subtree height is 0. So it is balanced one. Okay. So there is no need to perform any rotation. Next let us insert 4 now. So insert 4. So what is the tree here? 11, 5, for 5 the children is 2, next for 11 the right subtree is 32, next left subtree 20, right subtree 40, okay. Next we have to insert 4 now. So 4 is less than 11, so left side, 4 is less than 5, so left side, next 4 is greater than 2, so it becomes right children, okay. Next you calculate the balance factor. For 4 it is 0, for 2 0 minus 1 minus 1, for 3 so this left subtree height is 2, 1 plus 1 2, so 2 minus 0 it is 2. So we can say that it is balanced one. Okay, now there is no need to calculate balance factor for the remaining nodes. Why? Because 5 is unbalanced one. So which rotation we have to perform now? Here we inserted 4 here. Okay, so 4 is inserted left subtree right children. So this is nothing but LR rotation. LR rotation. Left subtree, right children. Left subtree, right children. So LR rotation means we have to perform two rotations. First rotation is left rotation and then we need to perform right rotation. So first let us perform the left rotation. Left rotation. If we perform the left rotation, then what will happen is here 11 is the root node. Okay. Next we need to perform left rotation on 5 to 4. If we perform the left rotation, then what will happen is we get left skewed binary tree. Left skewed binary tree. So what will happen now? What is left skewed binary tree? Each node value is lesser. Okay. So this is nothing but left skewed binary tree. Whereas this is nothing but right skewed binary tree. So let us perform left rotation now. Now, if we perform the left rotation, then we will get 4 here and 2 will be moved towards left side. So 5. Next we will get 4, next we will get 2. So this is nothing but left rotation. Okay, left rotation. Okay, so 4 will be moved towards left side, so 2 will be moved downside. Okay, next 3 by entry, so 32, next to 20, next to 40. So this is nothing but left rotation. If you perform left rotation, then we will get left skewed binary tree. So left rotation is over, so this is nothing but which rotation? LR rotation. LR means first left rotation, and then we have to perform right rotation. So if you perform right rotation, then what will happen? 5 will be moved towards right side, so that 11 will become the root node, whereas 5, 4, 2. So 4 will become the parent node, its left children is 2. 5 will be moved towards right side, so its right children is 5. Next 32, 20, 40. So here it is very, very simple now, okay? 5, 20, 5, 2, 4. Which is the smaller node here? 2 is the smaller node. So 2 will become the left children. 2 will become the left children. Next, which is the larger one? 4. So 4 will become the right children. So what is the middle value? 5 is the middle value. So this is nothing but the tree here. What is the middle value? So 2 is the smaller value. So 2 will become the left subtree. Next, what is the larger one? 5 is the larger one. So 5 will become the right subtree. Whereas what is the middle value? 4. So 4 will become the internal node. Okay. Directly we can write that one. So this is nothing but LR rotation. LR rotation means first we have to perform left rotation and then we have to perform right rotation. If we perform left rotation, then we will get left skewed binary tree. Okay. Then after that, perform the right rotation. Likewise, we can perform RL rotation also. If you perform RL rotation, then first we need to perform the right rotation and then left rotation. Right rotation means we will get right skewed binary tree as the output. And right rotation, we have to perform this left rotation. So we will get output as like this. Okay. Let us insert the next element. So 4 is over. What is the next one? 27. So insert 27. So calculate the balance factor. So 0, 0. 0, 0, so 1 minus 1, 0, 1 minus 1, 0, 2 minus 2, 0. So it is balanced 1. So insert 27. So the previous tree is 11, 4, 32, next to 2, 5, 20, 40. Next, which element we are inserting? 27. 27 is greater than 11. So right side, 27 is less than 32. So left side, 27 is greater than 20. So right children. So calculate the balance factor. For 27 it is 0. For 20, 0 minus 1 minus 1. For 32, 2 minus 1, it is 1. For 11, 1. For 11 it is left subtree. So 1, 2, 3. 3, this is nothing but 2. So 3 minus 2, 1. So there is no problem here. For 2 it is 0, for 5 it is 0, for 4 it is 0. Next, for 11 it is already calculated, 2 minus, for 11, so 2 minus 3, it is nothing but minus 1. Okay, so all are balanced 1 only, so there is no need to perform any rotation. Now let us insert the next element. What is the next element? Insert 23. So what is the previous tree? So 11, next to 4, next to 32, next to 4 children, 2, 5, next 32 children, 20, is 40, 27, next which element we are inserting? 23, so 23 greater than 11, right side, 23 less than 32, right side, next to 23 is greater than 20, right side, next 23 is less than 27, so it is left side. Now calculate the balance factor. So it is 0. Next 1 minus 0. It is 1. And next one 0 minus 2 minus 2. So here we got unbalanced 1. So we need to perform the rotation. Which rotation we have to perform? This is nothing but R. This is nothing but L. So first we have to perform right rotation. And then we have to perform left rotation. If you perform the right rotation, then we will get right skewed binary tree as the output. So 11, 4, 2, 5, next to 32, next what is it children, right children, 40, next perform which rotation, RL, that means first perform right rotation, we will get right skewed binary tree as the output now. So here what will happen is right rotation means so 27 will be moved towards right side, so we get 23 here. So 20, next 23, next to 27. So right rotation is over. Next we have to perform which rotation? Left rotation. So this is nothing but right skewed binary. So 11, 4, 2, 5, next 32. What is this, right children? 40. Now what will happen? We need to perform left rotation. So 20 will be moved towards left side. So 23 will become the parent node. So 23, 20, 27. So let us calculate the balance factor here. 0, 0, 0 minus 0, 0, 1, 2. So 2 minus 1, 1. For 2 it is 0, for 5 it is 0, for 4 it is 0 minus 0 means 0. For 11, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. So 2 minus 3 minus 1. So it is the balanced one. So very, very simple here. 20, 27, 23. Which is the smaller value here? 20 is the smaller value. So 20 will become the left children. Next, which is the larger value? 27 is the larger value. So 27 will become the right subtree. Next, which is the middle value? 23. So 23 will become the root node. So 23, 20, 27. Okay. So with this insertion of 23 is over. Next, insert 28. Next, insert 28. So insert 28. So this node. So what is the previous node? 11, 4, 2, 5, 32, 23, 40, 20, 27. So 28 greater than 11 right side, 28 less than 32 low, so left side. Next to 28 greater than 23, so right side. Next to 28 is greater than 27, so right side. Let us calculate the balance factor. So 0, so 0 minus 1 minus 1. For 23 it is 1 minus 2 minus 1. Next for 20 it is 0. For 40 it is 0. For 23, for 23 what is the height of the left subtree? 1, 2, 3. Right subtree height 0. So 3 minus 0 means 3. 1, 1, 2, 3. So 3 minus 1 means 2. So we can say that it is unbalanced one. So which rotation we have to perform? So we inserted 28 towards this right side. So this is nothing but left subtree. So this is nothing but right children. Whereas if you inserted 28 here, then the rotation will become the left-left rotation. Okay. We inserted 28 towards the right child. Okay. Left subtree, right child. So we have to perform LL rotation. So if you perform LL rotation, first which rotation we have to perform? First we have to perform the left rotation. Or directly perform the LR rotation. Okay. It is our choice. If you perform the LR rotation, then what will happen is, first let us write the tree now. So 11, next to 4, next to 2, next to 5, next to 32, 23, 27. Which is the smaller value? 23. So 23 will become the left children. Which is the larger value? 32 will become the right children. Next to 27 will become the internal node. Okay. So 27 is the internal node here. So 27. Next its left children is 23. Its right children is, what is its right children? 32. But before 32 here we have 40. So first write that 40. Sorry, what is the right child? 32. 32. Next attach the remaining nodes. For 23 the left child is 20. Next 28. So where we need to insert 28 here? 28 is nothing but 32 left children. Next 40 is nothing but 32 right children. Okay. So like this we can perform the rotations. So 0, 0, 0, 0, 0. So 1 minus 1 it is 0. For 23 it is 1. For 27, 2 minus 2, 0. For 4 it is 0. For 11, what is the balance factor? 1, 2. 1, 2, 3. So 2 minus 3 minus 1. So all are balanced here. So we got the entire nodes 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Let us insert the last element. So what is the last element? Insert 50. Insert 50. So we have to insert 50 now. So if you insert 50, then where we need to insert 50? So 50 is nothing but the largest element. So we have to insert 40 right child. So 50 balance factor now is 0. So let us calculate the balance factors now. So So what is 50 balance factor? It is 0. For 40, this is 0, 0 minus 1, minus 1. For 28, it is 0. For 32, 1 minus 2, it is minus 1. For 27, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. For 2 minus 3, it is minus 1. For 2, it is 0. For 5, it is 0. For 4, it is 0. Next, for 11, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. So 2 minus 4, minus 2. So here we got unbalanced 1. So what we have to do now? So which rotation we have to perform? So 50 is inserted towards the left child, right child. So this is nothing but RR rotation. So RR rotation means we have to move this 11 left rotation. So we have to perform the left rotation here. So if you perform the left rotation, then what will happen? 11 will be moved towards the left side. So 27 will become the root node. So 27. So if you perform the left rotation, then 11 will be moved towards the left side. So 27 will become the root node. So 27 will become the root node. Next 11 will become its left children. 11 children are 4 is its left subtree. 4 children 2, 5. Next year we have 23 and 28. So 23 will become 11 right children. Next 20 is nothing but 23 left children only. Next for 27 the right child is 32. For 32 the left child is 28. Next this is nothing but 40. 32 right children, this is nothing but 50. Just calculate the balance factor. 0, 0, 0. Next 0. 1 minus 0, 1. 0. Next 0 minus 1, minus 1. For 32, 1 minus 2, minus 1. For 11, 2 minus 2, 0. For 27, 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3, 0. So we can say that the entire tree is balanced 1. So in this way, we can construct AVL tree for the given elements.